If you just purchased WatchGuard Endpoint Security, you came to the right place. Let's take a look at how to get started protecting your endpoints. I logged into WatchGuard Cloud at cloud.watchguard.com, and from the dashboard, I can go to Monitor or Configure at the top and select Endpoints. From here, I can navigate between the tabs at the top to see lots of great information like the detections and other dashboards on the status page, a list of my computers protected by WatchGuard Endpoint Security, settings to configure the WatchGuard endpoint agent, and tasks to run automated scans and patches on a schedule. I will start on the computers list, and I have already created a few example groups that my computers will reside in. Groups are easy ways to organize our computers so we can apply settings and manage them separately. Think about how you want to organize the groups in your account before you start deploying agents. It can save you time later. Now I will download the agent installer. In this example, I will choose Windows, but all of the major operating systems are supported. Make note of the discovery option as well. Our agent can detect other unmanaged Windows computers and remotely install itself across a network. Click the link here for more information. When I install a new computer, I need to choose some basic settings, including the group the computer will be added to. When I download the installation file, it includes these selections, so you could have separate installers for different types of computers. On my endpoint, I just need to run the installer and complete the wizard. After that, the agent does the rest. It takes just a few minutes for the installation to complete. By default, you will find an icon for the agent available in the system tray that you can use to open a local dashboard. Back in WatchGuard Cloud, if we take a look at my settings, I want to highlight the workstations and servers category. This is where we configure our protections to make sure the endpoint is secure. You can create multiple profiles of settings to enable different configurations for different types of computers. I will click Add in the top right to create a new profile. Let's take a look at a few things you might want to adjust. Please note that I am using WatchGuard EPDR in this video, and depending on your licensing, you may not see all of these options available. In the General section, you can add custom alerts that appear when users encounter denied content. It can be helpful to add contact information for users to follow up with. In the Advanced Protection section, take a look at the operating mode. This defaults to hardening mode for Windows, and I recommend using that for 2 weeks in a new deployment. Afterwards, go ahead and switch it to lock mode to ensure unknown applications are not executing on your endpoints. Take a look at the Firewall, Device Control, and Web Access Control sections as well. All three of these features are disabled by default, and you need to decide if they are useful for you to enforce endpoint firewall rules, control devices connecting to your endpoints, and control the websites that users can access. I also want to highlight the per-computer settings. By default, the agent prevents itself from being uninstalled by asking for a password. If you need to uninstall the agent, you can find the password here under the anti-tampering section. Create your own per-computer settings to set a custom password or turn anti-tampering off. Check out settings for shadow copies as well. This Windows feature enables you to restore previous versions of files on the computer if they were changed or even deleted. The WatchGuard Endpoint Agent will protect the shadow copy backups against removal so they are available when you need them. Now that I have some new settings I want to use, I can go back to the computers list, click the three dots next to my All group, and change the settings. Under Workstations and Servers, I will select the new profile I just created, and since I applied this to my All group, every group and computer in my account will now inherit these settings by default. That is the basics to get started using WatchGuard Endpoint Security. From here, please explore the other available settings, configure tasks, and review any events in the dashboards and lists. To recap, get started with WatchGuard Endpoint Security by creating groups to organize the endpoints in your account and install the agent onto your computers. WatchGuard Endpoint Security supports all of the major operating systems. Review the workstations and servers settings to ensure the security protections are configured appropriately for your environment. If you need to uninstall the agent, check the per-computer settings for the password. To learn more about using WatchGuard Endpoint Security, please check the WatchGuard Help Center for written documentation and the WatchGuard Learning Center for additional help videos.